Hi everyone, my name is Katie Drewitz. I'm a local extension educator with the University of Minnesota. Today, we are going to learn how to take a soil sample from your garden or yard. What you're going to need to start this process is a simple hand trowel, a bucket. It doesn't have to be a 5-gallon bucket, but that is what I had on hand today. And then you will need the form that you can get from your local extension office and the soil sample bag, also from your local extension office. This is the soil test form that you will get from your local extension office. On here, you need to fill out just a couple of simple things: your name, address, and phone number, the soil location county, your check for the amount of money that you are, or for what it costs to get the test that you are getting. Most of the time, I have people start with a regular test. If there are deeper issues, we can always go deeper for next. Then you need to check the box that you are dealing with. In this case, I would check it for gardens, vegetable gardens. I also choose my soil test identification number here. This includes, can be any letter or number combination. In this case, since my name is Katie Drewitz, I would likely do KD. This is in our backyard garden, so I might put BG. So my code would be KDBG. To take your soil test, you want to take it from multiple locations in your yard or garden. On the back of the soil test form, it does walk you through these instructions in a very clear format. With the garden that I'm going to be using today, I have decided on 3 locations throughout my garden to ensure that I get a good sample of what the soil in my garden is. We have determined the 3 areas that we want to take our soil sample in our garden. So now it's time to actually take the sample. As you can see, this garden was covered in quite a bit of leaf debris and litter from overwintering. So I've cleared that away, and now we can start to take our sample. On your sample form, it does give you the instructions for a garden to go down 0 to 6 inches. I always like to go down in that 4 to 6 inch area. So we're gonna simply dig into our soil, and then we have our 5-gallon bucket, put that in there. I'm going to go ahead and do 2 scoops in my locations today. And then you're ready to move on to the next area. Let's go. So we have our 3 soil samples from our 3 locations in our garden in our bucket. Now we simply want to mix that around so that when we submit our sample, it's a nice even distribution of all the locations from our soil sampling site. All right, now that we have our properly mixed soil sample, we're going to put that sample into our sample bag. Now you will have wanted to write your name, address, and identification number onto your sample bag before putting the soil in, just so it's a little easier. So we open up that soil bag and we start to scoop in our soil. There is a maximum fill line on the soil bag. So it's going to take just a couple of scoops to get that in there. Once you're at that maximum line, you're going to simply fold down the bag and fold it closed. Then you will place your sample bag along with your filled out form into the mail and send it to the University of Minnesota Soil Testing Lab. In about 2 weeks, you'll receive your results back. At that time, you can read those results yourself or reach out to your local extension educator and they can help you interpret the results as well. Today, we have learned how to properly take a soil sample using the University of Minnesota Extension Soil Test Sample Kit. Again, these can be found at your local extension office, and the forms can also be downloaded online from extension.umn.edu. Now that you properly know how to take a soil test from your yard or garden, remember that this should be done once every 3 years to make sure that you are giving your plants the nutrients they need to properly grow. If you have questions, please reach out to your local Extension educator and they can assist you through this process. I'm Katie Drewitz with the University of Minnesota Extension, local Extension educator for horticulture, small farms, and local foods in Stearns, Benton, and Morrison counties.